Hello and welcome to Hank Games Without Hank. We're here in the Swindon County ground and in a stirring turn of events. It's raining in England. Today I am going to talk to you about the Euro 2012. We're going to discuss the second half of the teams that are qualified for the Euro 2012 finals that are going on right now. Beginning with the Netherlands, which is my favorite team. So we've established now that my top three teams in terms of my personal support: Holland, England, Germany. But of course, you can't say Holland because you just say the Netherlands. Just trust me. I learned this the hard way when I was in the Netherlands. So I lived in the Netherlands for 2 months. It's a place that's very close to my heart. By the way, we're playing West Brom today in the English Premier League. We need to win this game. It's the kind of game we should win. They're below us in the table, and we need to beat them. We continue, astonishingly, to be undefeated in the Premier League, thanks to our 9 ties. but we've been on a nice little winning streak lately. I mean, you know, things have improved significantly. Our team is a lot better. That helps. Oh, no. Oh, no. Everything worked out better than expected. All right, so, yeah, the Netherlands is my favorite team. And look, they haven't played beautiful football the last couple of years, and I understand that, but I have a long-standing the Dutch were the first – that was the first country to sell – to publish my book, first foreign country to publish Looking for Alaska. They supported me from the very beginning, even when I didn't have any readers. And that meant a lot to me, and so that's part of my loyalty to the Netherlands. But it's also just a great place, great, and I have great friends there. And I love the Dutch national team. I love its history. I love Johan Cruyff, and I want them to win. Now, that said, they probably won't win, so I'll root for one of the other teams. Get it in the goal! Leroy Williamson, I needed to settle and calm down. Oh, Leroy Williamson, if I just turned, I could have shot, and then I could have sung the Leroy Williamson song, but instead... No. Disappointment for Swindon. All right, what's next, Annika? Poland, co-host of Euro 2012. Poland published my first book, Looking for Alaska, and they published it very well, and they did it when no one else would. That predisposes me to like Poland. On the other hand, they didn't publish any of my other books. Admittedly, my first book was did not do terribly well there. But I always root for the underdog, and they're one of the co-most. Boots Wellington with some great stuff there. They're one of the co-hosts. You got to root for the hometown clubs. But, yeah, I don't think they're going to get very far. So, I mean, probably not. They're definitely not in my top 5. Maybe at the bottom of the top 10, but I'd have to rank it closely to be sure. All right, what's next? Portugal. I'll tell you, a lot of my books are published in Portuguese, but it's always Brazilian Portuguese. But The Fault in Our Stars is coming out in Portugal. I'm very excited about that. Couldn't be happier, etc., etc. But, yeah, I mean, they didn't publish any of my previous books, and they have Cristiano Ronaldo, so no support for Portugal. Not in my top 10. Definitely Portugal. I mean, if I'm going to rank my bottom 3, which, you know, you've got a top 3, you have to have a bottom 3. Portugal narrowly misses being in the bottom 3, but only because, Portugal's in the bottom 3. Yeah, right. They're third to worst. I would be, of the teams that could win, Portugal would be my third least favorite, with my least favorite by far possibly coming next. I'm not very good at the alphabet. What's next? No, I love Ireland. Ireland's great. They're not going to win, but they've got great supporters. I remember seeing a banner that some Irish supporters had that said Angela Merkel thinks we're at work. I just think they're hilarious, and they're very good-natured about, you know, not being one of the better teams in Europe. And so, yes, I'm all for Ireland. Poor little long-suffering Ireland. Hold on, I got to see who's calling. Hold on. It's my dad. Hi, Dad. I'm playing Swindon Town Swoodley Poopers. To Green. How are the defenders? Or no, we can talk now. Because this attack has got a bit of weight about it. I'm playing live. Oh, get in! All right, I'll call you back in a minute. Bye-bye. Oh, that's disappointing. That's disappointing. That was my dad. So, yeah. I mean, poor Ireland. They never do very well at these competitions, but they're always in a great mood about it. I don't know if it's explicit. That could have been a penalty, so I'm delighted that it wasn't. Ricardo Bunsen Burner. What? Ricardo? What? Were you? What is the possible explanation for your behavior there? Can I please see a replay? Save, followed by casually staring into the crowd. I mean, I'm going to have a talk with him at halftime. Is he upset? Because I don't know what the possible problem is. Okay. What's next? Russia. Russia is in my bottom three. Yeah, never published my book. Get it down. They're publishing The Fault in Our Stars, but they didn't publish anything previously. I don't even know if they are publishing The Fault in Our Stars. I think they are, though. They didn't publish anything previously, even when I begged them to, because I really like the country of Russia, and yeah, I actually got to Yuparuski a little bit. So I always thought it would be really fun to go there. But, yeah, Russia. Plus, I can't root for Russia while Putin's in charge. It's a policy I have. That's a terrible cross. Oh, disappointing first half from the Swoodley Poopers. It's still a 0-0 draw, but Ricardo Bunsen Burner had an exceptionally poor moment. I mean, really uncharacteristic. All right. We're going to go into the tunnel. We're going to discuss things, and we're going to come out a better club. That was a frustrating first half, and we should be beating West Brom. We should be winning this game. And they almost had a great own goal there. That was our best chance, was their best chance. And then Ricardo Bunsen Burner just had a confused moment where he just basically walked away from the game as if totally disinterested. Fascinating. Oh boy, that's typical Swoodley Pooper football there. But we made it. Okay, what's next, Annika? Spain! What's worse than Russia and Portugal? Spain! Spain, not only will they probably win the freaking pulp freaking thing, in 2010, they ruined my VidCon by beating Holland in the World Cup finals. Admittedly, Holland played terribly and did not deserve to win. But, Spain. No, I do not support Spain. That said, there are a lot of nice Spanish nerdfighters. I support Spanish nerdfighteria. I just don't support Spain in the World Cup. Mostly because, like, I mean, Fernando Torres broke my heart when he left Liverpool. I cried one of the very few times I've ever cried from football. I was so upset. I mean, I know that he gave us $50 million and £50 million or whatever. I forgive the whole thing. The thing happened. I forgive it. I wish him well as a person and even as a player, but I don't want Spain to win the freaking Euros. No. What's next? Is there anything left? Sweden! I love Sweden. They published Var Är Alaska in 2006. They were an early publisher of my work, and I'm very grateful to them for that. But, yeah, I mean, I didn't. My Swedish publication life did not go great, it must be said. However, it's making a nice comeback. They are going to be publishing Tifios, so I'm grateful for that. I mean, you know, there's a team that's not in my top five, but definitely in my top ten, and I wish them. I certainly wish them well. And if they make it out of their group or something, that's one of the teams you're definitely going to support because it's from a neutral perspective. Look, I'm not European, and while I do have a great attachment to Holland, on some level, all of these teams are, you know, like I could take or leave all of them. So, you know, it's nice to think about. Let's see. I'm going to put in Beef Stock. He's earned it. And French the Lana. You know, I have to say, French the Lana has not done great out there, so I'm going to do this. I'm going to put him in the middle, and I'm going to bring in Mr. Pettinari. And other than that, I think I'm going to keep the squad the same, because you can't take out the John Greens while there is yet attacking to do, because they are far and away our best attackers. So we're just going to try to strengthen ourselves in midfield. I did the thing that people hate me for. Is Sweden the last team, Danica? Ukraine! Yeah, I've never been published in Ukrainian. It's the only country that qualified for Euro 2012 that still has refused to publish my work. They have not yet agreed to publish The Fault in Our Stars. I'm hopeful. If you're listening, Ukrainian publishers, it isn't expensive. I will give it to you. I just want the pleasure of seeing my work in your language. This is bad. This is very bad. Oh, Ricardo Bunsenbrenner, thank you. I was mad at you earlier, but that was very nice. So we're going to move. Okay, everything. And then, what are you thinking, putting out the ball, John Green? He's not gonna let that happen. All right, so we're moving into attacking mode. We're going to get aggressive, and we're going to win this game. We're going to find a way to win because we're the Swoodly Poopers, and we don't like nil-nil draws. We do? We do like nil-nil? Come on. Oh, okay, it's a corner. Corners are good for us. Can we bring in... What? Snookered? That's complete bull honky. That is ridiculous. Terrible, terrible call. Anyway, yeah, Ukraine, no. Not in my bottom three, just because they don't have the population of a Spain or a Portugal. And certainly not the rich publishing history of a Spain or a Portugal. I mean, the first novel was published in Spanish in Spain. And they can't get their stuff together to publish a little John Green. I'm just kidding. I just compared myself to Cervantes. I humiliated myself. All right. Okay, and plus we're playing poorly. This whole video has been a disaster, Danica. I blame you. Oh, that's a foul. How is that not a foul? All right. It's the 85th minute. To be fair, when we do score in these games, we often score in the last minute. So don't give up hope yet. Don't give up. There's ball John Green. He's fast. He's going to kick it to his husband. Oh, who's not in the right place at the right time. Just not in the right place. Oh, West Brom content just to clear it. We switch field. There we go. We're in the box. We've got two guys in the box. We've got someone at the far post. It's Ball John Green. We win the game. Oh, the heroism. Oh, John Green's ball. Another John Green's. They love each other and they love our team. Great finish from Ball John Green. Look at that snap header. Kablooey! And all of a sudden, we steal 3 points from West Brom. Yes! What a fantastic finish. Far post. I love it. I love everything about that finish. Beautiful stuff. Now we've just got to stop him for a minute. Oh, what a great finish. Oh, that's great. Oh. Oh, my gosh. Sorry, I'm having trouble getting over it. What? How is that possibly a foul? Okay. Settle in, Green. Oh. Yes, go. Go. Yes. Is that it? Smell your pits in shame, West Brom, because you just lost. Yes. Oh, what a great win for the Swoodly Poopers. Congratulations to Bald John Green. Oh, man. That was beautiful. Best wishes.